My name is Mawarati and I am from Faculty FAS, course Applied Physics.
You like chocolate?
Yes, of course.
Do you know any news regarding the halal issues of chocolate?
I think I remember years back ago when I was Form 3, there is a case that KKM found out there is a porcine DNA in the Cadbury chocolate, right?
Yeah. Have you ever wondered how KKM found the porcine DNA in the sample?
Maybe using the machines?
That's right. The mission name is FTIR. If you want to know how FTIR works to evaluate the halal food authenticity and traceability of chocolate, let's watch the show together. Welcome back, viewers. Today we have Dr. Laili, a renowned food technologist, joining us to discuss the evaluation process of halal food authenticity and traceability of chocolate using food instrumentation. Welcome, Dr. Laili.
Thank you, Ms. Fatiha. I'm glad to be here.
Let's jump right in. Could you explain to our viewers how food instrumentation is utilized to evaluate the halal food authenticity and traceability of chocolate?
Certainly, Ms. Fatiha. Food instrumentation involves the use of specialized equipment and techniques to analyze various properties of food products. In case of evaluating halal food authenticity and traceability of chocolate, we employ instrumentation to perform specific tests that provide us with accurate and reliable data.
That sounds interesting. Could you provide some examples of the food instrumentation used in this evaluation process?
Sure. One common instrument we use is a Fourier Transform Infrared FTIR spectrometer. This device helps us identify and analyze the chemical composition of chocolate samples. It can detect the presence of any haram forbidden ingredients such as gelatin or alcohol, which might compromise the halal status.
So the FTIR spectrometer is in identifying any potential non-halal components in chocolate. What are the instruments are utilized?
Another important instrument we employ is high performance liquid chromatography (HPLC). This instrument allows us to separate and analyze individual components in the chocolate, such as fats, sugars, and additives. By comparing the result with established halal guidelines, we can ensure the chocolate meets the necessary requirements.
That's fascinating. Are there any other food instrumentation techniques used in this evaluation?
Yes, we also utilize gas chromatography mass spectrometry, which helps us identify volatile compounds present in chocolate. This technique can detect the presence of any non-halal flavors or additives that may have been used.
All of the instruments you mentioned provide a comprehensive analysis of the chocolate samples. Are there any challenges or limitations associated with using food instrumentation in this evaluation?
Of course, while food instrumentation offers valuable insights, it requires skilled personnel and significant investment in equipment and maintenance. Additionally, the interpretation of results requires expertise to ensure accurate conclusion. So collaborating with experienced food technologists and utilizing validated methods help mitigate this challenge.
Wow, thank you, Dr. Laili, for sharing light on the use of food instrumentation in evaluating halal food authenticity and traceability of chocolate. It's clear that these instruments play a crucial role in ensuring accurate and reliable results.
You're welcome, Ms. Fatiha. It was a pleasure discussing this topic with you today.
And thank you to our viewers for joining us. Remember, when it comes to halal, chocolate or any halal food product, the use of food instrumentation helps guarantee its authenticity and compliance with halal standards. Stay informed and enjoy your trips with confidence. Goodbye for now.
Oh, that's how KTM found the first Indie and K in this place.
So now you know the types of machine that can detect protein input. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.